My son can be playing with his friends right after I came from work. So I can watch them play, which makes me super happy. And I just came at, I was off at 6. And I came home like around 6:10, really quick, because I was working only 5 minutes away from home. So as you can see, my son is playing with his friends there. So I found a really, really nice job. You know, for my education and for my possibilities and for what I really wanted in life, which is keep on taking care of my son and raising him without interfering too much of his schedules and routines, this could not be better. So let me tell you how all started it. If you watch some of my videos, it is one of them that is very depressing because I was feeling devastated because I said, where I'm going to be working? I have no idea. Where I'm gonna find a job that I will not be demanding and that will not put my life on schedules upside down, that I will not be able to follow, and eventually losing a job that I will find. Because that's, I was just thinking, why am I gonna find a job that I will eventually have to quit? Why wasting my time, you know? So all that, if you see that video, don't watch it. It is very devastated. But if you saw the kids, I love to see them play. But if you see that video, you will understand that I was devastated a few months ago because it took me months, almost 9 months, to find this job that I work for Capital Protection. And I'm very proud and very happy because I found a really nice group of people that I'm working with. And this is for special events. So the job is never the same and it's not a routine, boring routine, you know, like, I know and I understand that being a security guard is a job that they pay you to observe, but also can be very boring if you are only standing in one place and there is nothing going on and you stay there for hours. That's what I thought of being a security guard, but nothing, thank God, nothing like that. It is a lot of fun. You meet police officers because they work there and in the same environment as we are. And you meet different people and also you are socializing with a lot of people. Not only for your co-workers and the police officers that you meet, but also for the staff that works in these events. For example, I was working in the Citizens Arena. They have really nice employees, so. And also the people that were coming, be careful. And also the people that were coming to these events, I mean, all overall was super nice. And the schedule that I've been having last week was from 9 a.m. until 1 p.m. So that gave me the opportunity to pick up my son after school. No, before, I'm sorry. That gave me the opportunity to pick up my son at school because he gets off at 2:25. And be careful. Cuidado. And then school was over last Friday, and today is Friday, so this week I only worked 2 days, and the schedule from 11:30 until 6 p.m. And until from 11:30 until 6 p.m. I worked today and yesterday. So on Sunday, the day after tomorrow, I will be working at 8 in the morning until 2:30 p.m. So I'm really happy, you know, for now. Oh, qué susto. For now, I will be working 6 hours a day, a part-time job, because my son's father is helping us. So with my job and with his help, we are going to be fine. You know, we are going to be okay. The reason that this job is very good, for example, even though that pays only the minimum wage, but the good thing is that if you can work extra hours after 8 hours shift, they pay you overtime. So when he gets older, it's good to know that I will have an opportunity to work more hours as he needs me, I don't know, maybe less. Well, I'm not gonna talk about the future, but in the future, hopefully, I'm glad to know that I will be able to work more hours because his needs are gonna be weaker. Because his needs are gonna be also obviously more expensive as he grows, you know, kids, they want better things. So I'm glad that I have a job that really gives you hours so you can work as many as you can or want, and then that's how you earn your money. So hopefully that's what I will be doing, but for now, summer just began, so it's good because I can work a little bit more than when he's going to be at school. Because when he's going to be at school, God ahead, I will be only be able to work 5 hours. because after dropping him off at school, then I will have to go straight to work, and then I will have to leave work before picking him up at school. All this got ahead. But what I want to share is that I'm really proud to wear this shirt, you know. I'm really proud to be a security guard that I never imagined working. But to explain you a little bit more about my job, what I need to do is to check on bags and sometimes use the wand and check people out, you know, to make sure that they don't bring, you know, like knives or chains or things that they are not allowed to bring into the these stadiums, you know. They are very strict with different things that they are not supposed to bring. Hoping the best, you know, not thinking about guns and tragedies because I don't even want to imagine or think anything like that. So basically, as a security guard, I'm not armed, so we are just basically there to observe and to watch the safety of the people, and basically that's it. So they just pay you to observe. So it's a very laid back job, and if you suffer for anxiety or stress, this job I will recommend it, because it will not demand too much from you, and you will meet great people, and you will socialize, and they are really nice. You know, it's very laid back. It's nothing much for it that requires from you to do. Physical, you know, or you don't have a boss telling you every 2 minutes what to do, or keep busy, you know, because they love it in California. If you work in the minimum wage, they love to explode you. So if there is nothing to do, they will make sure that they find something for you to do. Like washing windows, you know, whatever. Cleaning the floor, mapping the floor, I mean, whatever. They will make sure to find something for you to do. In the business of a security guard, they are very respectful. They don't bother you. They just obviously expect you to be a professional. And obviously, if they are going to pay you to observe, they want to make sure that you are observing, because, you know, your attitude, your corporal attitude, speaks for you. So it's not for you just to be standing like thinking at what time I'm leaving, then for you to be standing and really observing the surroundings and making sure that everyone is safe. You know, as a mother, as you can see, I'm always watching. We are always watching after our kids. So being a security guard as a mother is easy. It's not a difficult task, because as a mother, I'm always watching everywhere around my son. Wherever he's going, whomever is coming or leaving, or cars approaching, or different things, you know. Alan, ¿a dónde vas? Or now, like, I don't know, my son went all back there in the building and probably the ball went away, so. But anyways, I'm very excited and very happy to be finally employed. It's the first time that I haven't been working since my son was 2 years old for this long, almost 9 months. Without working. So I was very used to work only on the weekends and during the night, so I didn't have to worry too much about not being with my son, and I always wanted to raise my son myself. So this is the first time that I really needed to worry how I'm going to be raising my son if I have to work during the day, when my son has his days to leave and me to take care of him, because during the nights kids are asleep, so they don't need us. They do still need us, because you cannot just leave your house and go to work or go to the movies or go with friends or go to a bar or go anywhere, you name it. You have to be at home, but they need us differently, obviously. During the day is the only hours that we have to raise them well to become really good human beings. And as a mother, you can only do that. Nobody else will do it better than you. No one. Everyone else can help you and make it better for you, but no one is gonna make it better than you. As a mother, I'm sure of this. So I'm very happy that I just came from work. I'm gonna now take a shower. And then after my son ends playing here, which is gonna be a while probably. He usually plays until around 8 p.m. After that, I'm gonna order pizza for them because it's Friday and that's what I promised. And that's it. That's it. So I just will be blogging a little bit about his dinner time. It's not that I don't want to cook. I do have the energy to cook for him, but on Fridays usually we order pizza. It's pizza day. Not every Friday, but you know, sometimes we do this. So today they are going to be having pizza for dinner, and they are going to enjoy the night. I mean, they are going to enjoy. So they're going to be enjoying pizza for dinner time, and then I will be blogging a little bit about that. Okay, so what are you doing? And tomorrow I'm not working, so I have the whole day for myself and my son. And then, like I said, I will be working Sunday from 8 a.m. until 2:30 p.m. And in my first paycheck, I'm gonna use it on me, you know, because I haven't spent almost a dollar in me all these months that I was not working, that I wasn't working. My son's father obviously sent money for the groceries only, pay the rent only, so I did not have an extra coin for me. So the first paycheck that I'm going to have, I already told myself, I'm gonna color my hair and I'm gonna make it beautiful again. Because all this white that you can see, I hope it doesn't show too much on the video, it is terrible. I don't like it because I never let my hair grow this long. And all this because I did not have the money for it. Because I just did not want to go to a cheap salon and ruin my hair. So that's why I needed to wait. So now I'm super excited because what I'm gonna be spending with my first paycheck, it will be a nice salon so I can fix my hair. And also I'm gonna buy a nice shampoo and conditioner. So imagine what I've been going through when it came to money. I mean, I did not have an extra coin. I'm not overreacting or exaggerating, not even an extra coin. So the good thing is that I don't regret it anyways, because I had with my son the best time of my life always, even with no money. So now with a little bit of extra income, imagine God ahead how happy we are going to be, and I will be sharing all of it with you. Okay, so I guess I see you later. What happened, Junior?
Is that it?
That's it.
Yay!
Alright, can we go get
it? Let me play with you. Let me see if I can catch one. Let me see. No, no, no. Let me. It's my turn.
No, I know. I'm going
to
drink.
Okay.
Are you right?
No, no, no. But I don't want to keep
it.
I did it.